everyone, this is the second problem for Kaushik. Okay, start opening stock value, closing stock value. Opening stock of finished goods, closing stock of finished goods. Opening stock of work in progress, closing stock of work in progress. Material purchased, direct wages, factory overheads, administrative overheads, selling and distribution overheads, sale of scrap, next one sales. These are all the transactions is available for preparation of cost sheet here. Okay, let them do. First of all, opening stock value. The opening stock value is to be treated as a prime cost. That's why, look at the board please. Stock as on 1/1/1990. How much? 5,000. So, add purchases. How much amount material purchased here? Material purchased. How much? 50,000. So, total 55,000. Next one. Look at that. Closing value of material 6,000 is there. The 6,000 deducted from 55,000 less stock as on 31st 12 1990. How much? 6,000. So rupees 49,000 rupees treated as materials consumed. This one is to treated as materials consumed. Okay, next one. Direct wages is there. The direct wages relates to prime cost. So, direct wages. How much? 15,000. So, 64,000. The 64,000 is to be treated as prime cost. 64,000 is to be treated as prime cost. Add 8,000 rupees. Okay, look at the board please. Factory overheads 8,000 rupees. Factory overheads, how much? 8,000. Okay, 72,000. Next one, sale of scrap 500. This 500 rupees deducted from 72,000 because this is the income, not expenditure. So, sale of scrap 500. So, 71,500. Next one, work in progress opening value added. Next one, closing value less from the total. Okay, add work in progress. Work in progress as on 1/1/1990. How much? 8,000. So, 79,500. Next, less work in progress as on 31st 12 1990. How much? 8,000. So 71,500. This 71,500 amount to be treated as factory cost. Next, add office overheads. Okay, see this one. Administrative overheads is nothing but office overheads. So, administrative overheads. How much? 6,000. So total 77,500. Closing value of finished stock. Add. Finished goods as on 1/1/1990. How much? 15,000. 92,500 less finished stock as on 31/12/1990. How much? 12,000. So 80,500 treated as office cost. Next one. Add sales and distribution overheads. Okay. Let them say sales and distribution expenses or overheads. How much? 5,000. Okay. 85,500. This is a simple problem. Next one, last one. Sales. How much? 1,15,000. Right. Profit. This is the total cost. Profit. 1,15,000 minus 85,500. That is equal to total 29,500. Okay, let them see once again. Opening stock of finished goods, prime cost. Opening stock of finished goods, add materials purchased 55,000. Less, okay, closing stock. How much? 31st 12 1990. Closing stock as on 31st 12 1990, 6,000. Okay, 55,000 minus 6,000, 49,000, treated as materials consumed. Next, direct wages. Direct wages, how much? 15,000. Okay, all the direct expenditure should be recorded under the head of prime cost. So, the total prime cost is 64,000. Next one. So, the factory overheads. These factory overheads added to the prime cost, then we find out the factory cost. Okay, once again, all the factory overheads added to the prime cost, then we find out the factory cost here. Okay, see this, factory overheads. How much the factory overheads? 8,000. 64,000 plus 8,000, 72,000. Sale of scrap, it is not expenditure, it is an income. That's why minus 5,500, that is equal to 72,000 minus 500, 71,500. Next one, opening value of work in progress, always added to the factory overheads. Opening stock of work in progress, always added to the factory overheads. That's why add 71,500 plus 8,000, 79,500. Next one, closing stock of work in progress. The closing stock of work in progress must be deducted from the above total. So, minus work in progress as on 31st 12 1990, 8,000. So, how much amount we are find out here? 71,500. This 71,500 rupees amount to be treated as a factory cost. Next one. All the office overheads, this office overheads added to the factory cost. Office overheads added to the factory cost. Then we find out the office cost. If office overheads added to the factory cost, then we find out the office cost. Okay, let them see. Office overheads. Administrative overheads is nothing but office overheads. How much? 15,000. So how much? Sorry, how much? 16,000. So 71,500 plus 66,000. That is equal to 77,500. Okay. Opening value of finished stock must be added to the office overheads. That's why opening stock of finished goods as on 1190. 15,000, 77,500 plus 15,000, 92,500. Okay, next one. Finished stock as on 31st 1990, less. So 12,000. Then we find out 80,500. This 80,500 rupees amount to be treated as factory cost. Sorry, office cost. So 80,500 rupees amount to be treated as office cost. Then sales and distribution expenses should be added to the office cost. Then we find out the total cost. Here the sales and distribution overheads rupees amount 5,000, office cost 80,000. 80,500 plus 5,000, that is equal to 85,500 amount to be treated as a total cost. Next, the sales transaction is there available in the problem. How much amount sales? The total cost is 85,500. Sales amount is equal to 1,15,000. So sales minus total cost. Sales price is more than of total cost. That's why we find out the profit here. 1,15,000 minus 85,500, that is equal to 29,500. We are got it from the profit here. Okay, this is the cost sheet as on 31st 12 1990 of X Limited. Okay, this one is the another important problem, most important problem it is. Okay, from the following information, from the following cost data, prepare cost sheet. Stock of raw materials, opening stock of materials, finished stock, that means finished stock 1-1-2002, okay. Work in progress opening value, purchase of materials 1,50,000, factory overheads 25,000, direct wages 1,00,000, selling expenses rupees 10 per unit sold, right. Administrative expenses 15,000, closing stock raw materials 30,000, finished stock 2000 units, the units is available here, not the value, question mark. Okay, it is the question mark for this, because we have to be find out what is the value of finished stock for 2000 units. Next one, work in progress 20,000, right, units produced, number of units produced 12,000. Next one, selling price per unit 45 rupees per unit. Okay, sales price per unit 45 rupees per unit. Okay, what is the problem it is? Once again, look at the problem please. Stock of raw materials, closing value of stock, right, prime cost. Stock of finished stock 1-1-2002 60,000. Okay, this is the related to office overhead. Work in progress as on 1-1-2002, this is related to factory. Purchase of raw material, purchase of raw material is to be treated as prime cost. Factory overheads, factory. Direct wages, okay, prime cost. Selling expenses, so the selling expenses is rupees 10 per unit sold. Okay, sales and distribution expenses. Administrative expenses is nothing but office overheads. Closing stock, raw material closing stock is to be treated as a prime cost. Fixed stock, number of units available here, that the value is not available, that's why you have to be find out the value here. Next one, work in progress, the closing stock of work in progress 20,000. This is the, this transaction recorded in factory overheads. Units produced 12,000 units. Okay, selling price per unit rupees 45. Okay, let them see most important problem. Okay, number of units sold not available in this problem. First of all, number of units sold not available in this problem. Okay, look at that. First of all, cost sheet. Cost sheet as on 31st 12 2002. Please be concentrate. Most important model, most important transactions is available in this problem. Okay. Particulars, amount, rupees, amount, rupees. First of all, stock of raw materials. Okay, opening stock. That's why. First of all, this cost sheet for number of units produced. How many units produced here? 12,000 units produced here. Number of units produced 12,000. So this cost sheet for 12,000 units. So the following expenses are expended for 12,000 units. Okay. So number of units produced 12,000 units. That all the expenses are related to 12,000 units here. Don't be forgetting that one. Okay, right. First of all, opening stock. You know very well. Opening stock relates to prime cost. So, stock of raw materials. How much? 45,000. Right. Stock of raw materials. Add purchases. Purchase of raw material. 150,000. Add purchases. How much? 150,000. So 195,000. Next one. Closing value of raw material, how much? 30,000 less closing stock, how much? 30,000. So 1,65,000 rupees treated as materials consumed. Okay, next, any wages? Yes, direct wages. Look at that, direct wages. How much? 1 lakh. Direct wages 1 lakh. Total 2,65,000. This is to be treated as, you know very well, prime cost. Next, add factory overheads. Factory overheads, 25,000. So, factory overheads, how much? 25,000. Add. Okay, opening stock of work in progress is available here. How much? 15,000. Add work in progress as on 1/1/2002. How much? 15,000. 15,000. Total 40,000. Next. It is also be over. Next, closing stock of work in progress is there. How much? 20,000 less work in progress. Work in progress as on 31st 12 2002. How much? 20,000. So less, that's why 20,000. So 2,85,000. This is to be treated as factory cost. Add office overheads. So where it is? Administrative expenses. Look at the board, please pay attention. Administrative expenses. How much? 15,000. Okay, right, 15,000, total 3 lakhs. Next one, this 3 lakhs rupees for 12,000 units. Don't forget at that, the 3 lakhs expenditure expended for 12,000 units. The 3 lakhs rupees expenses are expended for 12,000 units. Don't be forget at that, because why? Number of units produced 12,000. Okay. Add stock of finished goods. Okay, stock of finished goods, opening value is there, na? It is to be treated as office overheads. You know very well. So, finished stock as on 1/1/2002. How much? For 3,000 units, how much? 60,000. Right. 3,60,000. Next. Finished stock, closing value. Okay. Less finished stock, closing value. The value is not available here. Only units is available. So, how do we find out the units value? 2,000 units value, we must be find out. Okay. Finished stock as on 31st 12 2002. It is okay. Look at that. This 3,000 rupees cost for 12,000 units. For 12,000 units, cost is 3 lakh rupees. Okay, the 3 lakh rupees are expended for 12,000 units. How many finished stock units is? 2,000 units is there. So, for 2,000 units of, the value of 2,000 units, the value of 2,000 units of finished stock, question mark. So, 2,000 by 12,000 into 3,000. 3 lakhs, sorry. Once again, I am telling that the 3 lakhs rupees expended for 12,000 units. The 3 lakh rupees expended for 12,000 units. Okay. How many units is there? The closing stock of work in progress, the closing stock of finished stock, the closing stock of finished stock is equal to 2,000 units. The value is not available here. Okay. Look at that. For 12,000 units, rupees expended 3 lakhs. For 2,000, how much? Okay, 2 lakhs by 12,000 into 3 lakhs. 2,000 by 12,000 into 3 lakhs. Okay, 50,000. So, 3 lakhs, 10,000. This is the value. So, 2000 units finished stock value is to be how much? 50,000 rupees. 2000 units finished stock value is equal to 50,000 rupees. How we are calculated this once again? So the 3 lakhs rupees is expended for 12,000 units. For 12,000 units expended 3 lakhs. For 2000 units, how much? 2000 by 12,000 into 3 lakhs, that is equal to 50,000. So the 50,000 rupees value for 2000 units of finished stock, right? This is office expenses. Next one, office cost. Add sales and distribution expenses. The sales and distribution expenses are not available. The sales and distribution expenses, okay, selling expense, 10 units per unit, okay. So number of units is not available in this problem. That's why we have to be find out the number of units here, okay. So look at the board, please. Number of units produced, 12,000. Opening units, 3,000. 12,000 plus 3,000 minus closing stock, minus closing number of units, 2,000. So once again, look at the board, please. Number of units produced, the units, number of units sold is to be calculated like this. Look at the board, please. Number of units produced, 12,000, add stock of finished stock as on 1/1/2000 to 3000 units, okay. 3000 units finished stock opening units, okay, plus 3000 minus closing units of finished stock, 2000 units, that is equal to 12000 plus 3000, 15000 minus 2000, that is equal to 13000. Okay, 13,000 into, okay, how much? 10 rupees per unit sales price, 10. So 1,30,000 is to be treated as sales and distribution expenses. So 4,40,000 is to be treated as total cost. Total cost 4,40,000. Next one. Right. Sales. Number of units sold. How many units? 13,000 units. 13,000 into sales price per unit. How much? 45. That is equal to 5,85,000. So profit, sales price is more than total cost. That's why 5,85,000 minus 4,40,000. That is equal to 1,45,000 is to be treated as a profit. Okay. Right, it is correct. Okay, right. Once again, look at the problem, please. Stock of materials. Okay, this is the opening stock of, this is the opening stock of raw materials. This is the opening stock of raw materials, 45,000. No problem at all. Next one. Stock of finished stock. This is the opening stock of finished stock. This is related to office overhead. Next, work in progress. Opening stock of work in progress relates to factory overheads. Raw materials purchased. Look at one. Raw materials purchased. 1,50,000. 45,000 plus 1,50,000. 1,95,000. Next one. Closing stock of raw materials. How much? Closing stock of raw materials, 30,000. Okay, so 30,000. So 1,95,000 minus 30,000, that is equal to 1,65,000 distributed as materials consumed. Next, what are the direct wages available? So the direct wages. So the direct wages is 1,65,000 plus 1,00,000, 2,65,000 considered as prime cost. Okay, the total direct expenses in this problem is 2,65,000. The 2,65,000 distributed as a prime cost. Next, factory overheads. What are they in this problem? So factory overheads. Look at this. Factory overheads 25,000 rupees is there. Okay, right. Factory overheads 25,000. Work in progress, opening stock of value of work in progress is to be treated as a factory overheads. So factory overheads add work in progress 1,12,000 to 15,000. 25,000 plus 15,000, that is equal to 40,000. Next one, closing stock of work in progress. The closing stock of work in progress is available in the problem 20,000. Okay, right? This one, work in progress as on 31st 12 2002, 20,000. 40,000 minus 20,000, 20,000. So 2,65,000 plus 20,000, that is equal to 2,85,000 is to be treated as a factory cost. It is. Next, office overheads. So all the office overheads are added to the factory cost, then we find out the office cost here. So what are the office overheads available in the problem? Okay, look at this one. Administrative overheads 15,000. Okay, administrative overheads how much? 15,000. Okay, next one, opening stock of finished goods is there. This is relates to office overheads. That's why stock of finished stock on 1/1/2000 to 60,000. Okay, so look at that one, 60,000. Next one, total is 3,60,000. Next one, the closing stock of finished units is available, but this is the most important point. The finished stock, the closing stock of finished stock units is available. The value is not available in this problem. So the value is find like this. So this all the expenditure 3 lakhs rupees. The 3 lakhs rupees is expended for 12,000 units. Because why? The number of units produced available in the problem 12,000 units. This 12,000 units, the 3 lakhs rupees are expended for 12,000 units. So finished stock as on 31st 12 2002, for 12,000 rupees, 3 lakhs rupees expended for 12,000. So rupees, how much amount for 2,000 units? 2,000 by 12,000 into 3 lakhs, that is equal to 50,000. So the total office cost is equal to 3,50,000. So what is the meaning of that? Finished stock units, 2,000 units finished stock value is 50,000 rupees. That value is to be calculated like this. Okay, 50,000. Total office cost 3,10,000. Next one, sales and distribution expenses. Number of units not available in this problem. So number of units sold not available in this problem. So the number of units sold is to be calculated like this. How we are calculated number of units here? So number of units produced, how many units? 12,000 units produced. Number of units produced 12,000 units. So opening stock of finished goods, how many units? 3,000 units. Total 15,000 units there. Okay, how many units of finished stock units? Closing stock of finished stock is equal to 2,000 units. Okay, so that's why the 13,000 units sold. So number of units sold 13,000. Once again I am telling that number of units produced 12,000 units. Okay, number of finished stock, number of finished stock opening balance 3,000 units, total 15,000 units. Number of units finished stock closing units 2,000 units less. So that's why total number of units sold, how many units? 13,000 units. So 13,000 into 10, that is equal to sales and distribution expenses 1,30,000. So the total cost is 4,40,000. Right. Sales. Sales price. How much amount the sales price in this problem? 45. Number of units sold, 13,000 units. 13,000 into 45, that is equal to 5,85,000. Sales price is more than total cost. Sales price is more than total cost. That's why profit. Profit is equal to 5,85,000 minus 4,40,000. That is equal to 1,45,000 is to be treated as sales price.